Okay, so now you are going to learn about the electron flow. So you have seen that the ammeter is fixed along with the electrical circuit in both the ends, that is in the positive one, and it is always fixed with the circuit, or it is fitted with the circuit which is having a series connection. The electron can only flow when there is difference of electric pressure. Okay, now what is the call electric pressure? For example, water flowing through a tube. It is only possible when there is high pressure at one side and low at another side. Then it will move from high pressure to low pressure. Now, the thing is that, say for example, you are switching on the switch. At that time, the bulb is glowing, or the fan is moving, or the TV is started. Now, in that case, what basically happened? Whenever you switch on, at that time, the flow of electron started. Right? So, the flow of electron is compared with the flow of water into a tube. For example, water flowing through a tube. समझ लो कि एक ट्यूब के थ्रू वाटर फ्लो कर रहा है. इट इज ओनली पॉसिबल व्हेन देयर हाई प्रेशर एट वन साइड, जब एक एंड में हाई प्रेशर होगा और दूसरे एंड में या फिर दूसरे साइड में लो प्रेशर होगा. एंड वाटर विल फ्लो फ्रॉम द हाई प्रेशर जोन टू द लो प्रेशर जोन. इन केस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करेंट, द फ्लो ऑफ चार्ज इज मेड पॉसिबल ड्यू टू केमिकल एक्शन विद अ सेल that generates the potential difference across the terminals of the cell. अभी हम लोग जो सेल या फिर जो बैटरी यूज करते हैं, इसमें एक केमिकल एक्शन होता है, एक केमिकल चेंज होता है whenever it is connected with a circuit. एक सेल या फिर एक बैटरी जिसमें केमिकल्स होते हैं, तो इसमें जो उसमें एनर्जी प्रिजर्व होता है. The energy is being preserved in that particular cell or in that particular battery. And whenever this battery or this cell is connected along with the electrical circuit, jab isko hum log electrical circuit ke through connect karte hain, to isme ek potential difference generate hota hai. Potential difference matlab like positive to negative. Because the current will flow from the positive to negative, and the electron will flow from the negative to the positive. So that generates the potential difference across the terminals of the cell. Because we know that in a particular cell, there are two terminals. One is positive, another is negative. If you see a battery, you can see that in one end, that is the top end, it is written plus, and in the lower end, it is written minus. So where it is written plus, that means this is the positive terminal, and where it is written minus, that is the negative terminal. So that's why there is a potential difference. Potential difference matlab ek pressure ka difference create hota hai. Jahan pe ek pressure zyada hota hai aur ek point pe pressure kam hota hai. So jo electric current hai wo jahan pe zyada hota hai, that is the high pressure zone, and jahan pe kam hota hai, that is the low pressure zone. High se low mein ये फ्लो करता है. सो इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस नीड टू बी नो. इट इज डिफाइंड एज द वर्क डन इन कैरिंग ए यूनिट चार्ज फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर बिटवीन द टू पॉइंट्स ऑफ एन इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट. इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट में दो तरह का पॉइंट होता है, जहां से फ्लो शुरू होता है और जहां पे फ्लो खत्म होता है. राइट? क्या मैंने बोला? इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट में दो पॉइंट होते हैं. एक होता है जहां से हम लोग इलेक्ट्रिसिटी का फ्लो स्टार्ट होता है और जहां पे ये खत्म होता है. सो इट इज डिफाइंड एज द वर्क डन, मतलब वर्क डन मींस व्हाट? द फ्लोइंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट हैज टेकन प्लेस इन कैरिंग ए यूनिट चार्ज फ्रॉम वन पॉइंट टू अनदर पॉइंट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट, दैट इज कॉल्ड द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस. सो वी कैन राइट potential difference, that is as a V, that is work done in carrying a unit charge. In carrying means what? Divided by Q. We know that Q is the net charge. So
we can get another formula, that is the potential difference equals to work done divided by net charge. The SI unit of potential difference is volt. It is also represented by V. Okay, so V is the measurement or the unit of potential difference. So we can write the potential difference as capital V, and
the SI unit is volt, that is also represented by capital V.
So this is the conception of electrical potential difference. That is, in one corner there is high, another corner is having low, and from this high to low, a net charge is carrying, and that is known as the work done. So I repeat this again. Say,
this is the electrical circuit that we are having. Say, this is the electrical circuit. It is going through this direction. So there is two terminals are there. Say, one is A and another is V. Now, what is the potential difference? That is, the current is flowing from A to B.
From this direction, the current is flowing from this direction, and it is known as the potential difference. That is, capital V equals to work done divided by net charge.
That is known as the volt, or we can say that is the potential difference from these two points. This is a point A and this is a point B. Okay, up to this, any confusion, anyone? Trisha, Mahi, Smriti, Riddhi, and Ali.
Sir.
Please ask.
So can we write the unit number as a centimeter per second?
Which one?
The current one.
No. For current, we have to write that ampere only.
Okay.
Mahi, any confusion? Mahi?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. The next one, that is 1 volt. Right now, we have studied about the potential difference. Now, why, when, or how we can express the volt? When 1 joule of work is done to carry 1 coulomb of charge, when 1 joule of work is done to carry 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another of a current carrying conductor, then the potential difference is said to be, or said to be, that is called 1 volt. So 1 volt means what? 1 volt. See this one. This is work, right? And this is net charge. So let's find out another relation. We have written capital V equals to W by Q. Now, what is the unit of capital V, that is potential difference, that is 1 volt. So what is the unit of W, that is joule, that is 1 joule, divided by, so one is 1 joule divided by coulomb, because the unit of Q is coulomb. So here we can write that 1 volt
equals to
one joule by 1 coulomb. That's it. So in that way, we can find out the definition of volt. Okay. So 1 volt equals to 1 joule by 1 coulomb. Means when 1 joule of work is done to carry 1 coulomb of charge from one point to another point of a current carrying conductor, then the potential difference will be 1 volt. Agar current carrying conductor mein ek point se dusre point mein kitna charge aata hai, 1 coulomb charge aata hai, aur jitna kaam hota hai usko hum bolte hai 1 volt. Now what is the voltmeter? It is an instrument used to measure the potential difference and represented by this particular symbol plus minus, that is V. So before that we have got another instrument that is called the ammeter, which is measure the current. Ammeter ka function kya hai? To measure the current. Voltmeter ka function kya hai? To measure the potential difference. Dono point mein potential difference kitna hai. So it is an instrument to use the measure the potential difference and represented by this particular symbol in an electrical circuit. It is always connected in parallel across the points between which the potential difference is to be measured. It has high resistance. So what is the difference? We have got another one. The ammeter is always connected along with the series connection, and the voltmeter is always connected along with the parallel connection to measure the potential difference between two parts. Let's see how it can be used. Say this is a series connection. समझ लो कि ये वाला एक सीरीज कनेक्शन है. दिस इज इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट एंड वी हैव फिक्स्ड द एमीटर ओवर हियर. सो दिस इज द एमीटर वी हैव फिक्स्ड ओवर हियर. सी दिस इज ए. ओके नाउ दिस इज द ammeter that has been fixed along with the series connection. So here we can give plus and here it is minus. Now think about a parallel connection. Okay, just like before. So whenever the electric current will be flowing through this particular circuit, just remember that here there is a point, there is another point. So if you just write down here, that is the A point and this is B. So there are two points you can see here, but whenever the current is flowing through this particular circuit, this is a parallel circuit as you can see, so the amount of current will be fluctuating, that is, that will be different. And in that case we can write over here, so here there will be a voltmeter. Here there will be a voltmeter. Here it can fix, or here you can fix this one. So in that case, so this is the voltmeter and this is also voltmeter. So here you can fix. Why? Because these two points are totally different, and in this way you can measure this. Okay, so voltmeter are always fixed with the parallel connection, whereas the ammeter is fixed with the series connection. Understood everyone? Trisha, Mahi, Smriti, Riddhi, Eli?
Yes sir.
Okay, others? Okay, Trisha?
Yes sir.
Okay, thank you. our next topic. So we have seen that
how this voltmeter and ammeter has been fixed in a particular electric circuit. Now, to understand a particular electric circuit, we need to go through a number of symbols. Okay, this will help us to understand what is the type of the circuit, how they are fixed. Say, for example, for cell, we use this symbol where two strands are there, one is long, another is short, having the positive and the negative terminal. If it is a battery, see, where more cells are connected to each other. And please remember that whenever the cells are connected, okay, they will be always like positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay, let me tell you, let me show you how they are connected to each other. Say you have taken a cell. Okay, this is a cell. This is another cell. Okay. So this is a cell. Okay. Now another cell is being fixed over here. Now another cell is being fixed over here. So how many cells are connected over here? Three. Just remember that it is always fixed like that. It is having a negative and positive end. So here it will be positive. And here it will be negative. Then again, here it will be positive. Here it will be negative. Then again, here it will be positive. So here it will be negative. So just see that there is a combination. You can see here a combination of negative and positive, right? Here a negative positive combination, here a negative positive combination. So the whole structure is known as the battery, but individual one is known as the cell. Individual one is known as the what? Cell. Ek single ko agar pakdoge to ye wala usko hum kya bolenge? Cell bolenge. But whenever we fix all these cells together, that will form the battery. So in a battery, just remember that this is positive, this is negative. So negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive. So what will be the direction? Direction will be from the positive to the negative. Okay? Always from the positive to the negative. But if you change the direction of the battery, then the direction of the current will also change. Okay? So this is the battery that I told you. See, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay. This is the symbol of the key or the switch, as you can see in the diagram. This is a portion which is a open. Open matlab, isme current nahi ja raha hai. Why it is open? Whenever it is closed, that is only the complete circuit. There are two types of circuit. One is completed circuit, another is incompleted circuit. Now, what is complete circuit? Whenever the switch is closed and each and every part of the circuit is closed, that means they are connected to each other. Each and every part of the, you know, that particular circuit are connected to each other, that is known as the closed circuit. But whenever any part of the circuit is disconnected, that would be known as the open circuit. So if the key is open, that means it is off. Switch off means what? Open. Switch on means what? Close. This is the symbol of the joint air, joint wire, that is three wires are connected in this particular point. Wires with no joint, if there is no joint, it will be looking like that. The symbol is used. For bulb, we are using this symbol. For ammeter, we are using this A at the middle with a round, and in both the side, positive and negative. In case of voltmeter, we are using the round along with V at the middle, and in both the sides, positive and negative. Okay, so this is all about the different symbols that we have learned today. So today we have covered what? We have covered what is called charge, then what is called net charge, how the net charge can be calculated, how the number of electrons can be calculated, then what is current, what is the unit of current, then ampere, then what is milliampere and microampere, their differences, what is ammeter, how it is fixed along with a particular circuit which is a series connection, and what is the flow of electron can be understood, which can be compared along with the flow of the water in a particular tube. Then what is potential difference, what is work and what is net charge, how these are related to each other, what is the SI unit of the potential difference, that is volt. Then we have learned about the voltmeter, what is the use of voltmeter. It is used in the parallel connection. Along with that, it is important to measure about the potential difference of the particular circuit. Then we have also studied the different circuit diagram, and along with that, what are the different symbols that is using in the electricity. In next class, we'll discuss about the relationship of current along with the potential difference, how the current and the potential difference are interconnected to each other with the help of a law that is known as the Ohm's law. Okay, so up to this, any confusion anyone today?
No, sir.
Okay, Mahi, Smriti, Riddhi, Eli?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So that's all for today. Take care, stay well, and stay safe. Thank you, and good night.